Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Math and Maticians, where we explore the lives and contributions of the greatest numerical minds of all time. Today, we dive into the fascinating life of David Shaw, a pioneer in both quantitative trading and computational biochemistry. How does one person even begin to master one of those things, let alone both? Buckle up, because David Shaw's story is one wild ride. David Elliott Shaw was born in 1951, a time when computers weren't exactly commonplace in the average household. But David wasn't your average kid. He was a self-described science nerd, fascinated by computers from a young age. His father was an engineer at Bell Labs, a renowned hub for technological innovation. Imagine growing up with dinner table conversations about transistors and lasers. This early exposure clearly had an impact because David excelled academically. He graduated from high school early and headed off to the University of California, San Diego. UCSD had a unique program that allowed undergraduate students to conduct graduate-level research in computer science. And guess who was all over that? Yep, David Shaw, already hungry to dive deeper into the world of computers, even before most kids his age had figured out how to do their own laundry. So David's at UCSD, soaking up knowledge like a sponge, but then he decides to take things up a notch. After graduating from UCSD, Shaw moved on to Stanford, where he completed his Ph.D. in computer science at the ripe old age of 24. But here's the thing about David Shaw. He wasn't just brilliant. He was also incredibly driven. He wanted to apply his knowledge to real-world problems, and he wanted to do it. So, what did he do? He became the youngest faculty member in Stanford's computer science department. Shaw was passionate about teaching and mentoring the next generation of computer scientists, but his own research was nothing to sneeze at. Shaw's main area of focus was computational biochemistry, using computer simulations to understand biological systems at a molecular level. Think protein folding, drug design, all that good stuff. He saw an opportunity to use his expertise in algorithms and parallel processing to tackle complex biological problems. It's the early 1980s and Wall Street is buzzing. There's this new breed of investor on the scene armed with algorithms and computer models. David Shaw noticed this shift. He saw an opportunity to apply his computational skills to the world of finance. So he took a job at Morgan Stanley. Not just any job, but a position in their newly formed automated proprietary trading group. He was basically a quant before quant was even a thing. Morgan Stanley at the time was pretty traditional, but they saw the potential of Shaw's ideas and gave him the freedom to experiment. He developed a groundbreaking trading system called TOPS, which stood for the Other Proprietary System. TOPS used sophisticated algorithms to analyze market data and execute trades automatically, all in real time. It was like something out of science fiction, but it was very, very real. Shaw was never one to shy away from a challenge. After a few years at Morgan Stanley, Shaw realized he could have an even bigger impact if he had the autonomy to pursue his own vision. So in 1988, he started his own hedge fund. This was D. Shaw & Company, a firm that would become synonymous with quantitative trading. Shaw handpicked a team of brilliant minds from academia and the tech world. D. Shaw & Company quickly gained a reputation for its cutting-edge trading strategies. They were basically the Jedi Knights of the financial world, wielding algorithms and supercomputers to exploit market inefficiencies. Under Shaw's leadership, the firm flourished, attracting billions of dollars in investments and generating impressive returns. But here's the thing that really sets David Shaw apart. Just as his company was reaching the pinnacle of success, he decided to step back from the day-to-day operations. While he was clearly a brilliant businessman, his true passion was always science. He never lost that scientific curiosity that had driven him since childhood. So, in the early 2000s, he transitioned to the role of chairman and chief scientist, focusing more on his research in computational biochemistry. Shaw's legacy extends far beyond his personal wealth. He's mentored and inspired generations of scientists, engineers, and entrepreneurs. Now, let's dive into the nitty-gritty of what D.E. Shaw and company actually do. Because let's be honest, quantitative trading can sound a bit like a magical incantation. At its core, D.E. Shaw and Coetzee's approach is all about finding patterns and exploiting inefficiencies in the market using sophisticated algorithms and massive amounts of data. Imagine trying to find a needle in a haystack the size of Mount Everest. That's kind of what quantitative traders do, except the needle is a profitable trading opportunity and the haystack is the vast ocean of financial data. To tackle this challenge, D.E. Shaw and company employs a multi-pronged approach. They use statistical arbitrage, which involves identifying and exploiting pricing discrepancies between related securities. Think of it like buying something at a discount and immediately selling it for a slightly higher price. Sounds simple, right? Well, the trick is doing it at scale and speed, which is where the algorithms come in. They also leverage machine learning, which allows their trading systems to adapt and evolve over time. It's like having a trader who never sleeps, never gets tired, and constantly learns from new data. Kind of terrifying when you think about it, but also incredibly effective. And then there's high-frequency trading, which is all about speed, speed, speed. We're talking about executing thousands, even millions of trades per second, all based on lightning-fast algorithms that can identify and exploit fleeting market opportunities. Shaw's work has had a profound impact on how markets operate, how investments are managed, and how financial institutions think about risk. You can't run these complex trading strategies on just any old computer. You need serious computational firepower, and D.E. Shaw and Company spares no expense in building and maintaining its technological infrastructure. We're talking about state-of-the-art data centers, custom-built hardware, and some of the most sophisticated software ever created. In the world of high-frequency trading, even a millisecond can mean the difference between a huge profit and a devastating loss. One of Shaw's key innovations was the development of distributed computing systems. Instead of relying on one giant supercomputer, he linked together thousands of smaller, cheaper computers to create a massive parallel processing network. It was a radical idea at the time, but it allowed D.E. Shaw and Company to achieve unprecedented levels of computing power. They even developed their own programming language called DesRem, specifically designed for financial modeling and high-performance computing. It's like the elvish language of quantitative finance, incredibly powerful, but only understood by a select few. D.E. Shaw and Coetzee's technological prowess extends beyond just trading. They've also made significant contributions to the field of computational biochemistry, developing software and algorithms that are used by researchers around the world to study protein folding, drug discovery, and other complex biological processes. Shaw's work has had ripple effects across countless industries, from finance to healthcare to scientific research. So, we've established that David Shaw is a brilliant scientist, a successful entrepreneur, and a bit of a visionary. But he's also, and this is important, a genuinely good dude. Throughout his career, Shaw has been actively involved in philanthropy, focusing on causes related to science, education, and global poverty. He's donated millions of dollars to support research in renewable energy, climate change, and sustainable development. He's also a strong advocate for STEM education, believing that everyone should have the opportunity to pursue their passions in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. He's funded scholarships, supported educational programs, and even taught computer science to underprivileged students. Perhaps his most notable philanthropic endeavor is the establishment of the Shaw Prize. Founded in 2002, the Shaw Prize is an annual award that recognizes individuals who have made significant breakthroughs in astronomy, life science and medicine, and mathematical sciences. When you achieve the level of success that David Shaw has, it's only natural to wonder, how much is this guy actually worth? Well, according to Forbes, as of 2023, his net worth is estimated to be around $7.9 billion. But Shaw's legacy extends far beyond his personal wealth. He's mentored and inspired generations of scientists, engineers, and entrepreneurs, many of whom have gone on to found their own successful companies and make significant contributions to their fields. He's also helped to shape the landscape of modern finance, pioneering the use of quantitative trading strategies and pushing the boundaries of what's possible with technology. His work has had a profound impact on how markets operate, how investments are managed, and how financial institutions think about risk. For someone who's achieved so much, David Shaw maintains a remarkably low public profile. He's not one for flashy cars, extravagant parties, or self-promotion. In fact, he rarely gives interviews and prefers to let his work speak for itself. Those who know him describe him as intensely private, deeply intellectual, and relentlessly curious. He's a voracious reader, a lover of classical music, and a passionate advocate for environmental conservation. He's also known for his quirky sense of humor and his love of puzzles and games. David Shaw is a fascinating study in contrasts. A brilliant scientist who's also a savvy businessman. A technological innovator who's also a dedicated philanthropist. David Shaw's story is a testament to the power of human ingenuity, the importance of interdisciplinary thinking, and the potential for technology to solve complex problems. He's a true pioneer who's helped to shape the world we live in, often from behind the scenes. His legacy is still being written as D.E. Shaw & Company continues to innovate and push the boundaries of quantitative finance. And while he may have stepped back from the day-to-day operations, his influence is still felt throughout the firm and the industry as a whole. As we look to the future of finance, one thing is clear: quantitative trading is here to stay. The algorithms are getting smarter, the computers are getting faster, and the amount of data available is only going to increase. But amidst all this technological advancement, it's important to remember the human element. It takes brilliant minds like David Shaw's to design these systems, interpret the data, and make informed decisions. Shaw's work has had ripple effects across countless industries, from finance to healthcare to scientific research. And that was David Shaw, the man who brought hardcore science to Wall Street. I don't know about you, but I find his story incredibly inspiring. It just goes to show that with enough passion, intelligence, and maybe a little bit of healthy impatience, you can achieve amazing things. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more fascinating stories about the greatest minds in mathematical history. Let me know in the comments who you think we should profile next. Stay tuned for our next episode in the series. Until next time, stay calculating.